Hey guys, I am Sankalpita and you're watching BookGeeks India, which is a channel where I make book related videos. If you like books, if you love reading, make sure you subscribe to my channel, like and share my videos, turn that notification on. And guys, please do comment because you know it that I love it when you comment. In this video, I bring to you 5 5-star book recommendations. All of these books have been read by me and I gave all of these books 4.5 or 5 stars. So rest assured, be assured that all these books are going to be wonderful reads if you try to read them. Now, these are the books that I'm going to be talking to you about. 4 of these books I read in hard copies. As you can see, one of them is a hardbound edition. The other 3 are paperbacks. And one of these I listened to as an audiobook and it was wonderful. And now, without further ado, let's just begin. So the first book that I'm going to talk to you about is this one, When I Hit You by Meena Kandasamy. Now, this is a book which I read last month and I was really surprised by how the author has written it. So it's actually a true portrait of the author's marriage, an abusive marriage which she went through for a long time before she finally decided to quit. So basically, her husband was a communist, and in this particular book the author has tried to show us how her husband, who was a communist and who had such liberal views when it came to women empowerment, was the exact opposite at home. So when it comes to this book, it's not so much about the plot or the storyline, but the powerful writing with which, you know, she has voiced her opinion. Read it if you want to read a revolutionary read. Read it if you want to try something really different. Something which is not really a novel in the exact definition of a novel, but a compelling read nevertheless. The next book that I'm going to talk to you about is this one. It's a classic, guys. So this one is The Dracula by Bram Stoker. So I read this book because I gave myself a target of reading a lot of classics this year. And because I was falling short, so I decided to pick up a classic. And when I browsed through a lot of files on Kindle and on LibriVox, I found this one. But I was so intrigued by it that I actually bought the hard copy as well. So I actually read this book in 3 platforms on my Kindle Unlimited, in the audiobook format and in this paperback edition. And let me tell you, it's a really good read. It's a little thick if you don't like thick reads. Like, it is actually around 365 pages. If you go to other editions, I think it will be around 400 pages. But nevertheless, it's a amazing book. So the story is about this England gentleman called Jonathan Harker who goes to Transylvania and finds out that people there are very superstitious. People there believe in a lot of things like evil forces or diabolical beings. So people there have really different kind of views. Now, being an English gentleman, being a well-read, well-bred gentleman, he doesn't believe in all this stuff. But that changes when he has to go to Transylvania and when he has to go to the castle of Count Dracula. So he goes there because his office sends him to help a certain particular gentleman to settle in England, and this gentleman is none other than the Count himself. So what transpires there, what all he experiences in Transylvania, in the castle of Count Dracula, is what this book is all about. This book is actually like a cult novel. If you're thinking about a really spooky read, this may not turn out to be that spooky. But when I was listening to the audiobook in the nighttime, I was definitely scared. So maybe it's not spooky when it comes to the current definition of spookiness, but yes, it's definitely a novel worth a read and I absolutely loved it. It was first published in 1897 and ever since then it has never gone out of print, never gone out of cult and never gone out of popularity. The next book that I want to talk to you about is this one, All the Lies We Never Lived by Anuradha Roy. If you guys follow me regularly, you would know that I recently did a video on this one and I can tell you that it was a fantastic read. So recently we had these JCB Prize for Literature Awards which were specifically meant for Indian authors and Indian literature, and this book made to the short list of this award. And on top of it, it really has a beautiful edition. It's just a beautiful, gorgeous cover. So let me tell you a little bit about this story. So basically this book is the story of a guy called Mishkin whose mother leaves him when he was just 9 years old. Now Gayatri Sen leaves her family, leaves her husband, leaves her son and leaves the comfort and the familiarity of a married life to pursue something else altogether in the Dutch-held Bali of 1930s. Why she goes there, what compelled her to leave everything behind in India, all this you'll get to know in this book. So this book, again, it's not so much about the plot or the storyline. It's a relatively slow read, but it's the compelling writing and the way the author has, you know, expressed emotions of Gayatri and Mishkin that, you know, makes this book a wonderful read. So if you're a literary fan, if you're a literary buff, you should definitely go for this book. Further, this book talks a lot about or explores the themes of loneliness, separation and guilt, and these are the central themes which are, you know, prevalent throughout the book. So I just loved reading this book. I cannot tell you enough how much I loved it. So definitely a must read recommendation from me. The next book that I'm going to talk to you about is this one, Tariksha by Khayal Patel. This book was fortunately sent to me by the author for review and I absolutely loved it. So if you guys have been following me, you would know that I love mythological thrillers and mythological fiction. And this book has the perfect combination of a mythological thriller, a fantasy fiction and also a historical fiction. So yes, oh my god, things could not have been better. The story is set in the 1820s of Rajasthan in a small kingdom of Devangar. Now Devangar is being constantly pushed by the Britishers to relent more and more. And these guys are not happy. They want to revolt. They don't want to succumb to the pressures of the British Empire and, you know, lose their sovereignty. So they are ready to fight. Now, in between all this chaos, when people are preparing for war, this kingdom of Devangar and the Britishers are preparing for war, the king mysteriously dies. Now, everything is left on the shoulders of the young prince Rudra Pratap Chauhan, and it will be upon him to win this war and the evil that is soon gonna haunt them all. So what is not known to all these people and also to the British people is that within the kingdom of Devangar, there is an evil force which can be dated back to the times of Ravan. And there are people in place and there are forces in place who want to bring that evil back. So will they be successful? Will Rudra be able to claim his sovereignty, fight for his freedom, and will he be able to divert this evil or perhaps kill this evil? To know all this and much more, I think you should yourself read the book. So this book is actually 330 pages and I absolutely loved every part of it. Now it doesn't have any dull moment whatsoever. Even though it's a mildly lengthy read, you would not feel like you are bored because, you know, every second thing, every second page, something new is happening, some new developments are taking place, some new plot twists are coming up, and there's a lot of action and adventure throughout the book. So that's the reason I would definitely recommend it to you guys. And I myself gave it like 4.5 out of 5 stars. Finally guys, the last book that I'm gonna talk to you about is a book that I listened to as an audiobook. So this was a fantastic read because I have been waiting to, you know, get my hands on this one for so long. And finally I did it. So ever since this book came out in 2014, ever since I saw it in the Goodreads Popular Choice Awards in 2014, I have been wanting to read it. But you know guys, the story of a book lover, the story of a book reviewer is always that there are a lot of books and only so many days. So coming back to the point, so this book is actually The Martian by Andy Weir, and oh my god, it's amazing. So this book basically is the story of this 6-person astronaut crew which lands on Mars to do their routine investigations. So NASA has sent them on a Mars mission to collect data, to do researches and whatever these guys do. So now they are on Mars. So their mission is supposed to last for 30 or 31 souls. I'm a little confused. And these souls are just like Earth days, except for the fact that actually soul is a little longer than an Earth day. I think it's 40 minutes, but I am again confused because I keep forgetting. Now, their mission is supposed to last for these 30 souls, and on the 6th soul, they have this huge dust storm which hits them, and it hits them all of a sudden, and it is of such ferocious capacity that actually the mission and the setup itself is not able to withstand it because it's not made to withstand it. So they had to abort this mission very quickly because otherwise they would all have died along with everything that they did so far. And in this process, because they have such less time to abort and, you know, go out of orbit of Mars, they actually leave a guy called Mark Watney behind. How that happens is for you to know, but yes, it was a confusion. There were serious indicators that they assumed that he's dead and he's lost, and they had to abort quickly, otherwise they all would have died. Now the next day, Mark Watney lives and he figures out that he's actually left alone on Mars. Everybody has left. And now he realizes that he's supposed to survive these hundreds and hundreds of days without any help from Earth, without any life-supporting equipment or life-supporting equipment and stuff, which is only meant to last for a couple of days. So Mark Watney does what nobody else has done in the history of mankind, and this is his story. I think it's a beautiful story of grit and determination and survival that, you know, everybody should read. So if you're a book lover and you like science fiction, and if you, even if you don't like science fiction that much, but you know, you can do with the science fiction, definitely go and read this book. You will not be disappointed. So that's it for me in this video, guys. These are all the books that I recommended you as 5-star reads. Go and check them out. I assure you, you will not be disappointed. And also, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Also, comment down below about which read are you gonna pick up next from this file. So that's pretty much it, and I'll see you in the next video, which will be pretty soon. Until then, bye.